G'day flight simmers, it's GA time. I'm putting the tube liners in the hangar today and we're going to do some GA flying. And we're going to be doing it in the Eclipse 550 taxi jet. It's called a taxi jet, it's not really a business jet. And we're sitting at Ketchikan Airport in Alaska on a rainy day. Although the sailing boats are out. Ketchikan ICAO is Papa Alpha Kilo Tango, and we're going to be flying a couple of passengers down to Vancouver. Charlie Yankee X-ray Yankee. They've got a connecting flight, so we've going to drop them off down there. It's going to be about a 2 hour flight. First off, we've got to do is get a GPU set up. I think the sound could be loud enough. Maybe just a little bit more. I'll always turn it down later. So, GPU is hooked up, ready to go. Now we've got to have a look at our weight. Now, what are our options as far as passengers are concerned? The captain, of course. Yeah, one adult alongside of it. And we'll put a couple of the passengers in the back. They do have luggage. And the other one's an empty seat. We'll make sure we've got plenty of fuel. Yeah, too heavy, so we've got to back off. That looks about it. Let's jump inside. And it's a bit noisy because the door's open. The door, and I might just get rid of the chocks as well. Better get a battery going, it'll do a few checks, and we'll do a check on the ELT. Nav can come on, beacon can come on. We organise something about a flight plan. I've used Route Finder for a route between Ketchikan and Vancouver. I've got an old one that I've kept before. I'll take that one. Activate. Right, so the route is from Ketchikan to Annette Island and all these waypoints. We've got an airway up there. Waypoints, another airway there. And there's Vancouver. Time to have a look at Abitab to see what sort of departure we can do. I much to choose from. Have a look at this one first. Well, that looks like a runway 11 departure. There's an empty on there, so so far that looks okay. Let's bring up Active Sky and see what runway we'll be using. Expected weather conditions to be expected, that's raining. Wind direction 170 over 6 knots. There's our Q&H. Canada runways for landing based on winds only is 11. I'll just make a note of that Q&H. 29039. Just have a quick look at the map. Yeah, looking, it doesn't look too promising along there. That looks like some pretty strong winds, but I'll try and avoid those. So, back to Abbey Tab, and it's runway 11, I believe. I'll just go back and check that. There's runway 11, and it's us. So we're going to go up this way. So now we can just put that out of the way. We'll look at our route here on the active flight plan. Load the departure. Runway 11. Going there, so it'll be none. And it's put in Annette Island for us, as the seat. Might go down here and get Otto the pilot up. We'll get our PFD over to a GPS. And we may as well put in our H. 2939. So we're actually going to be flying 25,000 feet, so that's right there. I'm going to use a IAS departure using the nav, and then we'll switch to autopilot once we're up. Flight director's already come on. Your damper can come on later. Yeah, that looks right. So all in all, it's looking pretty good. Get our engine started. But seeing we're going to be up at 25,000 feet, we must not forget to set our cabin air to norm, otherwise we'll be having blackouts above, I think it's 11,000 feet, is it? Get it started. If I remember right, 67 roughly. Yeah, close enough. Start our second engine. So I've set the takeoff on IAS. It'll automatically use 180 knots during the climb, and it will work out the how many feet per minute. It's probably going to be up about 2,000, maybe a bit more. Okay, both engines are working okay. Let's just check outside. And while we're out here, let's get a bit of a check. I might just drop that sound a little bit because it always comes through a bit louder. Hope that's all right. We'll set the takeoff flap. And put our taxi light on. And we may as well taxi out. Make sure our flight controls are right. Side stick on this particular aircraft. Let's have a look to see where we've got to go. To the right. And all the way back down there. Okay. Handbrake off. Oh, someone in a truck. Taxiing a little bit too fast. This, of course, is the Aerobask Eclipse 550, and I think it's personally one of the easiest of the little jets to fly. So, if you want a break from the tube liners, but you don't want to handle a prop jet, this is a pretty good choice. And one thing I do like about it, there's auto throttle. The only thing is you are not supposed to use auto throttle on ascent. Okay, when you're at cruise height, and also you can use it during descent, but apparently not supposed to use it during the climb out. We've got 2,000 in the box on standby. We get up. Once we get airborne, I'll change that to altitude. don't really need all the runway, but there's no taxi halfway. You've got to go all the way to the end. And of course, we don't have any windscreen wipers. The jet relies on the air pressure on the windscreen to push the raindrops off, and it seems to work. Okay, let's get our anti lights on and let's get our strobe on. No ATC on today or VATSIM, so we're on our own. And we'll do a rolling start. A little bit twitchy on the steering, but we'll see how we go. On full power. Get up to about 90 knots and we can lift off. There we go. Rotate. Positive rate, gear up, and we must at this stage back off on the throttle. If we run it at 100% in the red, it'll burn the engines out in about a minute or two. Flaps up, such an easy aircraft to fly. Let's put the autopilot on, and we're turning over to follow the route. Green banana showing us where we're going to reach our cruising level. And you can see we're already at 175 knots and we're climbing it well over what I said before, 2,000, nearly 3,000 feet a minute. And we're already in the clouds. Dirty weather there. Although, looks like we may be coming over the top of it. There's no bad weather showing up on the MPD. MFD. And we'll turn our taxi light off and our landing lights can come off. Temperature's still okay. Don't think there's any sign yet of icing up, so. See, the aircraft will maintain that 180 knots or thereabouts until it gets to top of climb. got the throttle just at 98.8. You can speed it up a fraction, but the idea is not to go into the red, or you will burn the engines out. And we're already up out of the bad weather. Not sure whether the sound is drowning me out here, but I will drop it down. When you're doing a recording, you only find this out after you've finished. Whereas, of course, if you're streaming, anybody who's following the stream can tell you if you're too loud or too soft. So it is guesswork. Temperature starting to drop here. When it gets to minus 10, I'm just going to, out of safety, put some ice protection on the engines. And we're still doing a fairly good rate of climb. Minus 10. Yep, let's put on our engine heat. Hopefully down the track, Active Sky will be able to bring us something better than this cross hatch, or whatever you want to call it, that you see. See it just everywhere there. Clouds probably aren't, these woolly clouds are probably, yeah, they're bearable. But it'll be good to see them if they come out with a lot better looking clouds. Now we'll be coming up to transition height shortly, 18,000 feet. Unfortunately, we can't see our passengers with the Aerobask Eclipse. Unless, I think we might be able to see them from outside. Someone in the back. Yeah, but not while we're inside. Right, we've just passed through transition heights, so we'll accept our QNH. Right, I might just stop the recording here, and obviously we'll be cruising along at 25,000 feet, and I'll come back when we're looking at descending into Vancouver, and by that time we might have an idea as to which runway we're going to be using. So, see you then. And here we are back again, guys. We're cruising along at flight level 250. I've dropped the speed back a little bit to 250 knots because I had to watch the fuel consumption there. It doesn't look too bad. We've still got enough. We've got about 123 gallons left. We're burning through it at roughly 80 gallons an hour, so that means we've got a little bit over an hour and a bit of fuel, but we'll be getting to Vancouver a long time before that runs out. So we're on auto throttle, your damper's on, everything is working okay, so the next thing we've got to do is have a look at the approach to Vancouver. Now you can see from the route menu here that we're heading to the next waypoint, Powell. That's 91 nautical miles, and we're going to be there in about 13 minutes. So while we're waiting to get there, we'll drag out a few of our charts. First off, though, I think we'll look at active sky, see what the weather's like. It looks like it's going to be some clouding over Vancouver. This looks like light to medium sort of rain. wind direction, etc. Looks like the winds are going to be from 80 degrees at 6 knots. There's some few clouds at 6,000, broken at 12,000. Doesn't look like there's a Q&H up there yet. But looking at this candidate runway, you're talking terms of 08 left, 08 right, or a runway 13. I'll come back to that for the Q&H hopefully. Let's get Abby Tab up. I've already sort of looked ahead on this just to get an idea which runway to take. So there's your 08 left, 08 right, and there's a runway 13. And because we're only a small little taxi jet, we'll probably go for runway 13. And I believe that this area down here is the GA parking area anyway, so that'd suit us to come to the end here and just park here. So we're going to have a look at the arrivals now. Yeah, there's that waypoint Powell I was mentioned before, so we're obviously going to be coming in this way. So this is the Kean to approach, sorry, arrival, down here to do the approach here. That looks like the one to take. And we'll have a look at runway 13. Be an ILS approach. Here's one of our waypoints here, I think, IGVAS. Come back. Not quite sure what this DATSI thing is coming over to 5300. And then 3900 here looks like some sort of a initial approach fix. Come back to that. So I move this out of the way and we'll have a look at our route map, a route chart, I mean. Have a look at the Vancouver, our arrival. There's an ILS 13 there, so we'll go for that one. There's the Kean to transition PAL. See how that looks. Yeah, not looking too promising there. So it looks like it wants to go to this Dupont, whatever that is. Let's see if I can have a look at the I'll put the plan in and see whether I can get some sense out of that. There's a flight plan. Yes, this little extension here doesn't make sense. That's a Dupont. See if I can get rid of that. Let's remove it. We've got another one at Sullery, we don't want that. Looks a bit better. I might go with that. Let's go back to our route. So the power of a pole, we've got 61 nautical miles to go. I need a cumulative mileage there, so I'll, I think I'll just go back to the MFD. Plan. Right, let's have a look at our estimated next waypoint is 8:28. Our estimate final, in which is UTC, 22 minutes to the final. Plan up again. So PAL 53 to go, and after that we've got 33, 37, say 38, 48, 48, 53, about 60. Oh, here's a total remaining 164 nautical miles. So if we start our descent about 100 out, PAL, and we've got 33, 40, here. Might start our descent at Powell. Better look at organising some our approach, sorry, our ILS details. So for that we go to Vancouver International there, and we put the that's what it was after. Runway, here we go, runway 13. Okay, ILS localizers. Frequencies of 111.10. We've set the nav one up here, so that's already there. And all we need to make a note of is that the heading's 125 degrees. Glide slope's 3 degrees. I think that's about all we need. Okay, so roughly in about 40 nautical miles, we might start our descent. So going back to Abbey Tab, we can have a closer look at the approach. Well, there's a 111.10 frequency, that matches okay. And just looking at the ILS descent. I think 3,900 might be the. As I said, I'm not quite sure what this is. It looks like it's a waypoint coming from another direction. I'm going to go with the 3900. Now, our decision height is 258 feet. That'll be the barrow. And 250 will be the radio height. Okay, you can go out of the way. Now, nothing to say we can't put in that height, 3,900. Because we're just going to stay now at 25,000, flight level 250. I might see if I can, I've got a decision height here already, 150. I'm not sure. Have a closer look at that. I'm not sure whether that's barrow. Oh, I should be able to make that go bigger. Let's try it here. Yeah, it doesn't say. Well, the decision height is either 250 out of 250, which is close enough. I'll put in 250. Not quite sure how this thing works. There we go. Alright, that's set. Let's go back and have a look at Active Sky to see if there's any update on the Q&H. Doesn't look like it. Looks like they've got a Q&H. Looks like that waypoint jukepod's got a Q&H of 3000. Might have to go with that. Anyway, when we get closer, I can check that out again. Outside temperatures minus 38 degrees. I've already got the left and right engine heaters on, anti-ice protection. Your cabin air has been set earlier, so that's okay. Seventy nautical miles to Powol, and another Powol. It's doubled up for some reason. I would assume they'll just ignore that. We'll see what happens. I've got different direction headings. Just have to watch that. So it should go to Powell first and then over to Quaddy. Look like there's any where they're showing up here on the weather radar, so it must be pretty good. Switch it around to that. Four nautical miles to go to here. For some reason it's going off track. Might just get that back up to salary. Looks like it's heading to Quaddy. I think we might start our descent. We'll start off at 1200. Vertical speed's on. just looking for our green banana and I can't seem to find it. Should be showing. Might try a faster rate of descent, see what happens. Oh, I know why. Forgot to hit the minus. He was climbing instead of going. That's better. Now there's our green banana. Must always remember to put that minus sign in front of it. Alright. And we want to be at 3900 at IGVAS, which is here. Going by the green banana, we'd reach that level about here, so we're probably not descending fast enough. We'll go for 250. 2500 and minus sign in front this time. Now watch the green banana come down here. Transposing it across, it looks like it's going to be pretty right, but we can adjust that as we go down. Just maintain our speed. I could probably drop that down. Let's just take it down to 240 at this stage. As you can see, you can use the auto throttle on this aircraft to descend. Check again for Active Sky to see whether there's been any update on that Q&H. Otherwise, I'm just going to go with the closest one of these waypoints at for 3000. And you can see there's not a lot of difference between what we're at now anyway. About to turn on to our finals. Well, not quite, but we're on finals when we get to IGVAS. Let's have a look outside, see what it's like. I think as we do the turn now for the next waypoint, that green banana is going to come a bit shorter than IGVAS. That means we can then drop the descent rate see that already, so might just take that at 2000. And again, I have to remember to put that in. And then the banana extends itself out. It looks like we've got some mountains outside. As long as we stay on course. Should get our red route marker there and come up. Yeah, as soon as it hits Muzon, there we go. And our banana's even pulled back further. So I think we can drop that down to say, let's say 700 feet. Minute, and it's extended out and lined up pretty well, so we stick with 1700 feet a minute. And I'm going to drop the speed down to 210. In fact, the banana's even pulling back further. So you can see here, it looks like it's even lined up the localizer. IGVAS is a little bit further along, so what we can do there, we can drop that to 1500 feet a minute. And it's extending out. Yep, and we're still right. So we probably can go down to 1,300 feet a minute and see what happens. Pretty good. It'll probably pull back a little bit more as we drop the speed off. And once we get to IGVAS and that slight turn there, we can activate our ILS approach or our VLOC. It's extended it out a little bit, might be because we're getting a bit of a crosswind here. Looks like the wind's affecting it. Now another look outside, see what's going on. That's a pretty rugged territory there. Make sure we don't get too low with the vertical speed descent. Yeah, in fact, what I might do is I might take that right back to about 800 so that we don't have any problem clearing these mountains, and we can fix the banana up, because now it would have extended further beyond Igvass. It's just playing it safe. When we get on over the top of these mountains here, then we can adjust the vertical speed again. Is hovering up there beyond the runway. So I think we can go back now and we can say 1500 feet, because we're going to have to come down a little bit faster. Banana's coming back down. And that was a good guess. Now let's drop our speed down now to 185. Make sure we're not gonna hit anything. Not the best of approaches to Vancouver from this direction. But it looks like we're pretty right. Now let's keep an eye on this. According to this, we're above the glide slope. That's what it's picking up. But we're still just below Igvass, so we should hit 3,900 before the initial approach fix. Probably going to be slightly below the published height, which is 3,900 or above. And in fact, we can slow it down even a little bit more. Let's try 1200 feet a minute, and we'll watch the green banana, they call it. So we're going to hit that pretty well at 3900. Just get some lights on. Landing lights are on. Our temperature outside is 2 degrees, so we don't need the ice protection anymore. September come down even to 165. Looks like the localizers just right where it is. We're just slightly below the glide slope. Speed's coming down now to 165. Another look outside. Bit of a frame rate hit there, but it's flyable. And we can even slow it down a tad more. What about 1200? Let's just go and see what 1000 feet a minute will do for us. Banana stretching out. And we can even go further, say 800 feet per minute. And it's not having a big effect. Up again. Looks like we'll be leveling out in a minute. There we are. Below the glide slope here. As soon as we get to Eclipse-550, we can turn cross over to Eclipse-550. In fact, I think we can probably do it now. And we should be able to activate the approach. And it looks like we've captured the glide slope. We're descending already. I'll drop our speed even further down to 140. And we should find ourselves turning onto the finals. Don't need this one anymore. And prepare for landing. first flap setting now. Airport, the runway. Speed's down 140. Synchronize our heading. Like there's no crosswind, so this should be a fairly easy landing, hopefully. Now put the gear down. And a nice steady approach. We do have a little bit of a crosswind there. Now it's coming from 60 degrees and at 3 knots. My aircraft. A bit high, sorry, a little bit low. and no call outs, unfortunately, on our minimums. From what I recall from that chart for runways and taxiways, we taxi all the way to the end. And by the way, there's no reverse thrust on this, you rely on brakes. Should have checked that cross runway there, but. Turn off, I'd say. Flaps are up. Taxi on. Landing lights off. The strobe can come off to beacon. There we go. And we'll taxi. And that looks like the GA area there. Let's see where we can stop this. I suppose here's a good place as any. Let's have a look. Overshot. Go over here to the right. Drop our passengers here off right about here, I'd say. Parking brake on. Taxi light off. We can turn everything off. Engines can come off. before I open up the doors, might have a look at how good the landing was. Go back a little bit. That'll do. Who wouldn't be happy with that? Have a look from the strip. Swing it over. She's smiling at me. And we'll have a look at one from the tower. Wasn't across one way. Although I think there's one up here. Yep, that's it. Okay, let's turn everything off. We can open up the door, put the chocks on. Passengers are departing. And back to cold and dark. Okay guys, so that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. A bit of a change from Boeings and Airbuses. Doesn't hurt for me to take this out once in a while just to have a bit of variety. So until next time, thanks a lot and bye bye.